My name is Harshit Omar, scholar of South Asia Foundation, researcher, United Nations volunteer also from Pondicherry University. So today this session is for introductory lecture, first of all, that why we should take political science and IR as an optional subject. As we know, there are various myths, okay, regarding this subject, okay. So first we will see what is the syllabus of political science and IR optional as a subject. So syllabus in paper 1, political theory and Indian politics, which is divided into two parts, section A and section B. Section A talks about political theory and section B Indian politics. Here we will discuss regarding various scholars, various philosophies, various thinkers, which will help us in our political science optional, as well as ethics also, as well as general studies paper 2 also, okay. So as far as my experience goes, I believe many of the students will be from non-humanities background, okay. So those students who are not from humanities background, they don't feel that there is any disadvantage, because I will start from the basics, okay. So we will not have any disadvantage, okay. But more than that, I want to make it a point, because I saw something in last batches also, I have realized that the way you have studied science subjects, it makes a big difference, because it is a political science. When you enter into the humanities, okay, so the knowledge is very subjective, okay. So because different people here may explain differently, like science, there is no 2 plus 2 is equals to 4. It can be 6 also, it can be 3 also, it can be 5 also, okay. It all depends upon how you are presented, okay. So there is no ideal way. So this is the syllabus of political science, okay. So political science and IR optional. In first paper we will study various thinkers, various philosophies and Indian politics, and in optional 2 paper in political science we will study international politics, global politics, okay. So the idea how to understand this subject, so one should not feel that the subject is very tough, okay. The subject is vast and dynamic. As you know, whole UPSC is dynamic now, okay. So in the very first day, okay, you may find a little bit troublesome in the sense, okay, you will be entering into a something very different kind type of universe of learning than it used to be, okay. But I feel that I am sure, I mean, that after a week you all will become very comfortable with the subject and you will start enjoying the subject. So far you should have patience with you, okay, and you will have to make some change in the way you have been study or other subjects, okay. So how to understand this subject, like you should have different opinion, you should have analysis power, okay, you should have power of action. There is no ideal way, so there will be no such concerns, but be open and relaxed, okay. That's the main thing, okay. So I would like to share that what type of subject political science is, okay. What type of subject political science is, as political science, always remember that science and politics, okay, the word itself is political science, but there is no science in the political science. Why? Because behind that also this is also a politics, that science has been added, okay. So there are various scholars who says regarding the use of this term, okay, that political science for the title of the subject regarding the science has been added, okay. There is some kind of politics, okay. So what is political science, we will see. So this is our introductory lecture, okay, where we will see how to study, how to understand the syllabus, द मेन थिंग इज हाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड हाउ टू राइट द आंसर्स. ओके सो आई ऑलवेज से फर्स्ट यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड ईच एंड एवरी कॉन्सेप्ट, देन आफ्टर दैट गो फॉर राइटिंग आंसर्स. ओके दिस इज द मेन थिंग. ओके सो देर आर वेरियस परसेप्शंस इन द पोलिटिकल साइंस. ओके दैट एंड आई मस्ट से वॉट बेसिक थिंग, देर आर सम बेसिक थिंग्स ऑल्सो, बेसिक थिंग्स ओके लाइक वॉट आर द परसेप्शंस. द पोलिटिकल साइंस विल हेल्प यू इन जनरल स्टडीज पेपर वन. ओके जनरल स्टडीज पेपर टू, जनरल स्टडीज पेपर फोर, जनरल स्टडीज पेपर थ्री ऑल्सो एंड एसे ऑल्सो. ओके वाई आई हैव रिटन दिस, बिकॉज द सब्जेक्ट इज वेरी डायनेमिक. ओके एज यू नो द होल यूपीएससी इज वेरी डायनेमिक. ओके सो दिस इज द मेन थिंग. सो आई वुड लाइक टू प्रिफर हियर द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज न्यूज़पेपर्स. ओके न्यूज़पेपर्स आर द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ अवर पॉलिटिकल साइंस एंड इंटरनेशनल रिलेशंस ऑप्शनल. सो वी विल सी व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ पॉलिटिकल साइंस. वी विल डिस्कस, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो व्हाट शुड बी द एबिलिटीज टू स्टडी पॉलिटिकल साइंस. यू शुड बी ओपन, रिलैक्स एंड पेशेंट. ओके so we will discuss here what are the advantages of political science optional. So I have already told you in the first session itself advantages taking it at optional. First of all, political science and IR is one of the main subject for your UPSC examination point of view also, as well as from your interview point of view also. Okay, so there are some key points which you should know. It is one of the most informative subject. And it is one of the necessary subject for any civil services exam aspirant looking forward to getting into the government as a civil servant. Okay, so any civil services aspirant who intends to serve as a bureaucrat must have a strong hold over fundamental of political science and has to be well aware of the political climate surrounded him or her. Okay, so there are various advantages of political science. As through this you can prepare Indian polity. Okay, Indian polity. Then if the aspirant chose political science and IR as an optional, they will have to study this along with this prelim section also. Thus it will save time for your prelims. Okay, it will save your time for your prelims. Okay, so in this way your preparation for UPSC prelims and mains can be integrated. Okay, so being slightly non-technical subject, aspirants can easily comprehend and study this subject even if they don't have political science as their background, because the concepts are general and anyone who reads newspaper on a regular basis would be able to understand and study the subject. Okay, so it will give you an understanding regarding the newspaper also in every manner. Okay, so we have seen the since 2008 the syllabus has got changed. So we will practice previous year questions papers since 2008. Okay, so the impression that the syllabus for political science is very vast and is only partially true. Why? Because in fact a lot of the topics are repeated lot of the topics in this paper. Like Marxism, okay, Marxist theories, so many times, always repeat. Then state theory, then Gramsci, all these things, okay. So many topics like thoughts of Mill and liberal notions of state, justice, democracy, these are much interrelated topics, okay. So first of all, what we will discuss, there are certain topics which will be covered in paper 1 and paper 2 optional of Pol Science, like liberalism, feminism, ideas of Marxism, issues of democracy, okay, issues of democracy and human rights, environment. So knowing a lot of content in this subject can also help in your IAS current affairs preparation also. And in interview also, in interview round also, a good knowledge of topics in polity like governance, IR can be very handy. So you can see there are so many advantages of this subject. Okay. So this is one of the main important subject for our general studies as well as our optional examination point of view also. Okay. So there are various benefits. It will help us in all the general studies paper and sections also. Okay. So I would like to tell you that most of the people have query like what kind of optional subject would they choose for a UPSC examination. And there is no easy. First of all, I must say there is no easy or tough optional subject. It all about your interest in the subject and sometimes your background, like your graduation also. So first thing that you should do is to go for general studies, okay. Then you can look the syllabus of political science, how the syllabus is interrelated with all the general studies paper, okay. So this is one of the main thing of for our political science as optional subject, okay. So like if you are from engineering background, then for your arts, polity, anthropology are all at same level, okay. Like you will be getting around 9 to 10 questions from the Indian freedom movement and 16 to 20 questions from Indian polity, like that, okay. So the biggest advantage with political science objective is that you gain broad knowledge of current developments that are going on, that you can utilize in the general studies sections also, okay. And the essay paper that you will be having in the UPSC examination will definitely have two questions from the political science. After choosing the political science subject as an optional for UPSC examination, you would be in a very good position to crack those two questions very well. Okay. So the very big advantage of choosing political science as an optional subject is relevance and interlinking properly. This is one of the most important part of our mains examination. Like in the previous year itself, in the essay paper, there was a question from the relevance of non-alignment movement, which is the topic from the international relations. And you will have fact, statistics and data prepared for these kinds of topics through political science and optional paper. And you can choose the knowledge of the political science subject in general studies subject also. And it becomes a kind of supplement for yourself, okay. So every year I think people from general studies paper, for the very simple reason, most of the topics are covered in the political science optional subject itself. Now if we are talking about political science as an optional, so here in general studies paper 4, if we link this optional through in ethic with ethics paper, so there is one part of thinkers that you study in the political offset part of optional subject, okay. And this will give you a great advantage review for the political science as an optional for yourself also. And in the interview itself, you will again the advantage because of your optional subject with few questions from international relations, okay. So there are various advantages why you should choose political science and international relations as an optional. So this is one of the most important optional subject, we can say. So first of all, what we will see, what is political science? A word itself has science. Okay, as we know, science is related to art, and politics is related to craft. So here we will study. What is political science? So political science is political science. What is politics? First we will discuss. Politics is a state craft. Okay, politics is a state craft, because politics refers to craft and science refers to art. So political science is a state craft. Okay, so we have seen various advantages for this PSIR as a subject. Okay, so we should know what are the advantages for this subject, so that we can prepare for this. Okay, so I must say, one should go for political science. It will be helpful in all your general studies paper. Okay, so this is one of the most important optional paper for any UPSC aspirant. Okay, so if we are talking about like political science, we will start our political science as an optional subject from the Socrates. So what Socrates says? Socrates talks about dialectics. Okay, and dialectics means debate. Okay, so political science itself and debate. Okay, so it will analyze, and in this subject you can analyze and you can gain your critical thinking. Okay, next, what are the material you should refer? First of all, my class notes and nothing else. Second is, you should have critical thinking, think and think more. Newspaper, anyone, whether the Hindu or the Indian Express. Okay, then Rajya Sabha debate, IR scholar views, not your views. Okay, not your views, first of all. Then previous year questions paper, most important thing. Previous year questions paper are most important part of our political science. Okay, so there are various advantages for political science and IR as an optional. Okay, that why we should take this political science and IR as a optional. So there are, I have already told you the sources. I never refer you books and all, only class notes and your concise understanding regarding the subject and topic. So it is a very interesting subject which tests your capability of integrating static knowledge with contemporary issues. Okay, your static knowledge with contemporary issues. This is one of the most important thing in political science. You will correlate your static knowledge with contemporary developments. Okay, here we will see. Okay, static knowledge with contemporary development. Static knowledge with current. Okay, so so we will see, apart from interest in the huge GS syllabus, okay, political science and international relations are also a part of prelim syllabus, also in mains also, like general studies paper 1, it is correlated with general studies paper 1, like freedom struggle and social issues. Freedom struggle and social issues. Okay, then general studies paper 2 also full social justice, constitution, polity, international relations. full general studies paper 2 will be covered in your this political science and optional subject. Then general studies paper 3, how? Security, internal security and environment. Okay, environment. Okay, then general studies paper 4, moral thinkers. Here in paper first you will understand the philosophies of various thinkers, then essay topics also, as I have already told you, non-alignment movement essay. Okay, so like these kinds of things. So the political science and optional, as a optional, is a very good subject, I must tell you, because it will give you an understanding regarding the all the syllabus, like all the general studies paper. So there are advantages and advantages in the subject. But the thing is, the syllabus is vast. As you know, the whole UPSC is vast and dynamic. So we need to prepare concisely, and we need to practice previous year question paper. Okay, so this is one of the very important part of our political science and IR paper. Okay, so in political science, I must say, there cannot be any automatic system. Okay, so we need to work in a very chronological manner so that we can understand each and every topic in a concise and subjective manner. Okay, so this is political science. This is the whole political science syllabus, how we should study. Okay, like in our subject, political theory and international relations can be linked to in Indian politics also. Okay, if we are talking about writing answer, so we cannot write a good answer until and unless a comprehensive picture of all the topics is in front of us. Okay, so in an so right now we should have the goal of plan of action. So right now, at present, I will say at least we will take 1 month a plan of action for understanding the topic. Okay, there is no need for writing answer in the initial stage. First you should have knowledge of all the topics. Okay, then you can write a good answer. That means first we should have one plan of action, should be understanding the subjects. Okay, so my way of teaching is, I always emphasize on logically understanding. Okay, you need not to mug up the things. There may be certain myth that in social sciences we have to mug up. No, it's not like that. Social sciences and political science in particular is a very logical subject. Okay, you should have an understanding that what is the relevance of this subject in the present time. So when you come to the class, the objective should be understanding the basics and the concepts. Application of mind is the most important thing. Okay, I never tell students to run after books. Okay, because it's no point. So it's a very conceptual subject. If a theory and the idea you can understand by the simple discussion which we will have, so there is no need for any book. Okay, that is the main thing. Okay, either you will understand from one book, otherwise a number of books, no point of understanding comes when we apply our mind. So we need more of a mental exercise. Okay, no amount of reading can be helpful if you are not an active learner. Okay, and if you are not critically analyzing things while you are doing things. So the very methodology of the subject, I will start with Socrates, then Plato, Aristotle. Okay, this is the main thing. Okay, so we need to understand each and every topic in a concise manner so that we can write answers. Okay, and one more thing, you will be not here to become an activist nor to do PhD in the subject. Your simple task only, how to get the maximum possible marks in the mains examination. And hence I always encourage questions, because questions and answer is the way in which political science is studied. But at the same time, try to restrict yourself and discipline yourself when you ask question, okay, that this question is relevant for exam or not. Okay, so otherwise there will be an endless debates continue, and we have Facebook and WhatsApp where we can talk on that. Okay, so be very professional. Okay, otherwise it's like a 5 years of syllabus which we have to cover in 4 or 5 months. Along with that, you understand. Okay, so it's a 5 year syllabus we have to complete within 140 to 150 hours, within 3 to 3.5 months. Okay, so you should have complete notes. Okay, so we have to follow certain disciplines also to be able to do that. Thank you for this discussion. Thank you very much.